not going to get anybody to put a ring on your finger.
What you may not know is that with 30 years of experience as master matchmakers, my mom and I often work with couples wondering if they should tie the knot. The fact is, he wants kids, she does, and I think she's just scared to let her body go. Is that true?
Yes.
Now, out of thousands of applicants, we've chosen 6 couples, all desperate to know if they've really found the one.
Welcome to Tough Love Couples Boot Camp.
Everybody here has room for improvement.
Do you guys kiss?
Sometimes.
No, we don't.
Sometimes.
No, we don't.
Okay, no.
Clearly, you guys aren't on the same page here. My mom and I are putting these couples to the test to see if they really are a perfect match. In the end, they'll either get engaged or call it quits for good. These two, they ain't gonna make it.
Steve, these people love each other.
Prove it. Every major issue that can break a marriage apart.
When it comes to sex, I'm just jaded by, like, porn and strip clubs.
Well, stop watching porn and strip clubs for a while. Take a break.
From communication, look at you. You're in her face, going like this, to sex.
Have you ever had an orgasm? Well, wonder why you're so frustrated.
To exposing their secrets and lies.
Did anything happen with that girl?
I took a shower there. I grabbed her boobs, Steve.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
I'll force them to face the truth.
I cheated 3 years ago.
You people have real issues.
You're taking this as a joke.
These are your real lives.
Your mom is going through a lot right now, Dennis.
Don't want to settle, no matter what. Don't settle.
And help them make the biggest decision of their lives.
I'm not trying to rush into getting married.
Yes, you are.
That's not what I'm trying to do.
Why do you want to do it right now?
Why the not?
The time for talk is over. Either you're going to get engaged or you're going to break up for good and never see each other again. It's going to be tough. Don't you think you're disrespecting Larry?
I don't give a His opinion does not affect and run my life.
I'm going to do everything I possibly can to save your relationships. But if I can't, then nobody can. I'll give them the tools. If you truly love each other, if you truly want to make your relationships work, get over your issues. Put them behind you.
I was scared. I didn't want to fail. I'm so sorry.
None of you are so damaged that you can't love somebody else.
I'm here because I want to make myself better and I want to marry her.
But in the end, they'll make the choice.
You know how much he loves you, right?
I didn't until we came here. And now I do.
I want to spend my last breath telling you how deeply in love I am with you.
But they'll have to make it.
Fuck you.
I'm going to get the fucking girl sack on you.
Do my Tough Love Couples boot camp first.
You're too short, you're too ugly. Get the out of here.
I'm about to lose my mind.
If you haven't figured it out yet, I'm not God.
Dysfunctional couples, we all know them.
The Dramaramas. Before you break everything in your home, maybe you should just break up. The Cheaters. Choose a bed and lie in it. On again, off again. Relationships aren't light switches. Make a decision already. Seriously, these people need our help. I'm Steve Ward.
I'm Joanne Ward.
And it's time for some tough love. Thousands of couples applied to be at this boot camp. And I'm giving these 6 relationships one more chance to make it work. First up, there's Mario and Christina. She's constantly searching for the truth in everything he says. But I don't think an orthopedist could find an honest bone in his body. I'll call them the Mistrustfuls.
The beginning part of our relationship was 1,000 miles an hour, like a lot of passion, a lot of love, a lot of sex, very fast. But Mario's lied about going out behind my back, going to strip clubs.
I'm not perfect, and I'll do what I do, but she's an attractive girl. Guys sit on her, too, and I don't beat her up about it.
So don't sit here and act like you don't freak out, because you're 10 times more jealous than I am.
I've cheated on every girlfriend I've ever had, except for Christina.
I mean, he says he hasn't, but again, I have trust issues with him.
All of my ex-boyfriends cheated on me.
I can't continue to just go down like a road of heartbreak. I love him too much to do that to either one of us.
We either need to get help together or get away from each other, and that's the bottom line.
Axelle comes by way of France, and she brought her attitude along with her. You'd think it'd be perfect for her rocker boyfriend, Ryan, but it just leads to fighting and heartbreak.
That is short.
I'm not a fan, babe.
Why not?
I'll call them the Dramaramas.
The major issue in our relationship, without a doubt, are arguing.
He would stand up, scream like crazy.
You're absolutely making
this up. Are you kidding? Seriously?
Meanwhile, on her Facebook page, some guy's saying, why don't you sleep in my bed naked? And she's saying,
joke.
Why not? It's not a joke to me.
And then what happened, Ryan?
tell the truth. I would say the principal issue is trust.
You realize you're kidding? Seriously? Think over the next 3 weeks, you know?
Has what? To
so
do
there's
that.
A time
has,
on and time off?
Has, you no, choose no, I never said I never said I was taking any time off.
The state of our relationship is a little rocky. And that's what brings us here today.
So I feel a little arguing, bit...
Arguing over stupid
you know,
things.
Exactly.
Arguing over stupid things,
well.
Exactly. Courtney and Dustin have been together since they were teenagers. And after 8 years, they still act like they haven't even graduated high school. I'll call them the high school sweethearts.
We both sleep in separate bedrooms and live kind of like roommates more than a couple.
I think the spark is gone. It's almost like it's so easy to be together that it scares us to be apart. I want to make the relationship work because, I mean, I love her, obviously. I know we can make it work if we just get some guidance.
I needed to know if we need to end things and finally move on or fix it and move forward.
Simone and Dennis used to be engaged, but Dennis's fear of commitment and of raising her two kids led him to call the wedding off. They've stayed together, but who knows for how much longer. I'll call them the Now or Nevers.
A year into the relationship, I proposed to Simone. In the back of my mind, reality kicks in. I'm not ready to take on this responsibility as a family yet.
It's not as though it would have been a new situation. We were already a family. It's been a little over a year since we broke off the engagement. I'm starting to have those days where I feel like maybe I should just throw in the towel. And I want to do something about it because I don't want to lose him. This is a last resort because I feel like we can't even discuss the topic of marriage.
I don't understand why it has to be rushed.
Every day I wait for him to propose to me again. So it's very hard.
Just nod your head. Are you really gonna stay there and stare?
And then there's Heather and Larry. He couldn't stand the heat, so he got out of the kitchen. Things still haven't cooled off, but he's begging Heather to take him back anyway. I'll call them the second chances.
Good luck with this. We met in September of 08.
He moved in 6 months after.
It sounded like a great idea, but we didn't know each other very well.
When Larry and I broke up, it was terrible.
It was a mutual breakup, I thought.
No, I never wanted to break up. I never wanted to. I mean, it got to a point where we had to. That was the hardest thing I've ever had to do in my life. I don't ever want to experience that ever again.
Till she says, no, Larry, this is not going to work. Have a nice life. I'm still going to keep trying.
Things have been going really well, but we're not officially back together. And I'm a little hesitant to take him back after everything that we have been through. You know, he broke my heart.
She's still hesitant.
How come you're so calm?
Why not?
This isn't scary for you?
It's scary.
I'm in this by myself, aren't I?
And last, but certainly not least, Danielle and Paavo got their wires crossed somehow. He's either primping himself or working out, and she's usually taking care of everyone else but herself. I'll call them the role reversals.
No turning back now, I guess. This is it.
We've been together almost 4 years now.
But I feel like I am the man. I do everything. I'm fed up with making all the plans and arrangements for us.
Before I get a chance to do it, she does it for me.
No, because if he doesn't do it, we sit and we do nothing.
Honey, I'm home!
I didn't realize that he threads and waxes his eyebrows. He flat ironed his hair. He's overly metrosexual.
No.
Yes.
I care about
this. Obsessed with his body.
It's our sex life. Do we even have one?
No.
Yeah.
Hello?
We pretty much have sex very seldomly.
Once a month.
It is turning into a friendship, you know, but the food's great.
Us doing this is something that's either gonna keep us together and help us out, or it's gonna break us.
Mama's scared.
Heather and Larry.
Nice to meet you.
What's up?
Hi, Christina. Nice to meet you.
All the new boot campers are settled in, but they seem a bit too comfortable. I've got to give them a little reality check.
Steve comes out, and everybody's face turned pale white.
Yeah.
I've never seen a more scared group of individuals. It was like we were in kindergarten, and the principal just came to talk to us because we're just all bad.
Welcome to Tough Love Couples Boot Camp. I'm sure you all think you know why you're here, but I'm going to tell you why I chose for you to be here.
And by the time you're done with boot camp, I'll expose and deal with every roadblock in your relationships.
Let's discuss some of the highlights.
I was like, oh my God.
Yeah, the first thing that ran through my head was, holy like, this is happening right now.
Coming up on Tough Love Couples. You've already asked her to marry you. You gotta man up.
I'm not used to anyone talking to me the way you talk to me.
I felt like, oh God, please don't fly off the handle.
You got a temper like a junkyard dog.
What the Nobody talks to Christina like that.
If you could marry your partner today, put on a tuxedo.
How am I supposed to do this right now? Run!
I was looking at the dresses and I'm like, getting hot. I don't know what to do.
I don't know how you guys can just not have sex with anybody else for the rest of your life.
And later.
Christina, I don't know any better.
That's dysfunctional.
I couldn't even be in the same room as him. I don't care if I ever see him again.